Wow, this is my favorite exercise of all time. I think it is the most necessary exercise in order to facilitate functional movement. There's never going to be a time in your life where you're not bending down to pick something up, which is why the compounds are so fun, because they keep you functional for the duration of your life. There are tons of semantics to this lift. There are so many different zealots for different types of form. Our main two are going to be conventional deadlifting, which is your feet inside of shoulder width, or sumo deadlifting, which is your feet outside of shoulder width with your hands inside of your legs. So we can get into the details of what bar type should you be using, and what is the difference between deadlifting with chain plates, which would be iron plates, or bumper plates. Can you facilitate this movement with weights at home, gallops at home, or weighted backpack? Absolutely you can. And what the form setup should be. I'm going to go through the cues that I really enjoy, and if you guys want any of those details on bar type, weight type, what the difference is between all of it, I can absolutely get into that in another video, or even I can reach out to you individually. Those are all very important factors that I think are seriously overlooked by athletes, and by doing so, by overlooking those aspects, oftentimes as an athlete, your environment is becoming a limiting factor to you, but in reality, you can be using equipment that suits your preferences. So, let's talk about setup. A big cue in deadlifting is that you should never set the bar up to you. You should always set yourself up to the bar. What I mean by that is that when I go to set up, do I bring the bar myself? No. The reason being is because when I stand up, wherever that bar is probably isn't my center of gravity. From here in the view, you can see that I have this huge gap between my shins and the barbell itself. This same principle can be applied to picking up weights in front of you, or picking up gallons or a weighted backpack. So instead, I'm going to set myself up to the barbell, meaning that when I approach the weight, I come up and I'm going to set myself up directly underneath. As you can tell right now, I'm going to be cueing a conventional deadlift. Now, this is cued completely different across the board. Everybody has a different feel for it, everybody has different engagement senses. My body type is different than your body type, just as I referenced in the squat video. So there are going to be multiple factors to this that is going to affect the way that you feel doing this movement versus how I feel doing this movement. Without tooting my own horn, I have a favorable body type for movements like powerlifting. My torso is very short, my legs are longer, and they maintain more muscle. I'm now at the stage of my blood system able to activate muscles such as my lats and my rhomboids, whereas previously, for years and years, I never knew how to get those muscles working. So these are big identifying factors that affect the way that I'm able to cue and understand my own body. If you have issues engaging any type of muscle when you go through the chain, or in feeling certain cues, you can always ask me about it. I'm more than happy to look at that. So, you'll notice that approaching the bar, I turn my toes about 45 degrees out. That's forbidden across the pool because it allows for the dry ride of the knees, which can help with engagement of the hamstrings and the glutes. Now, my shins themselves are about an inch away from the bar. So if I bend my knees first, which I shouldn't do, I'm going to bump the bar away. I like to set up down by the bar rather than up top because oftentimes I use it to setting up high, and by the time I get down to the barbell, first of all, I'm bumping it far away from myself, and second, I'm losing all my ability to hold. So instead, I like to get set up, my body set up to the bar, my toes are turned out, I'm going to drop my hips down and grasp a double overhand. Then, before I sink down, you'll notice that I'm starting to pull my shoulders back. So I like to wiggle one shoulder back at a time and pop my chest up because it gets me really tight and it gets my lats engaged. It also forces my spine to engage. My feet are making full contact with the floor and I'm pushing back my glutes to activate them. I'm going to sit down. I'm going to snap that bar a little tighter to the big inhale. I'm going to lift the bar up. My torso is doing exactly the same for my knees, then my hips come through. And that's how I narrowly consider what takes up. Typically, you guys have the bar. Then, on the way down, I'm going to pull my back tight, and the bar will start carving down the length of my quads before I start to drop my actual hips right by knee height. So, done quickly, it looks like this. and that would be your double overhand position. By double overhand, I mean both of my hands are overhand on the block. You'll see a lot of people do what's called mixed grip or supinated position. And the reason that they do that is typically because either they're having difficulty moving their back, so it helps them to retract underhand, or the bar might be rolling out of their hands, which can sometimes be because there's not enough knurling on the bar, and it's just too smooth, or your hands are sweating, or your grip might not be there. Yeah, sorry, I'm so waiting for that. So I would advise doing overhand grip until you just can't anymore. I've had the negative instance of developing one lat over the other by supinating too early. So always double overhand for as long as you can, for as long as you can keep good form. Then we have sumo, which I like to use the rings on the bar as an indicator. If you have weights, you're simply going to keep the weight in your center. My hands are now going inside of my pelvic girdle instead of outside of my knees, where before I was allowing for enough room for my knees to drive out. Here, I drop my hips slightly, but it's important that your chest doesn't collapse all the way down when you're doing a sumo deadlift because it puts you at a big risk of injury. I surprisingly do not have the adequate hip mobility for a sumo stance deadlift, although my anatomy would indicate that this would be the optimal deadlift for me. I lift conventionally when I do lift. But for setup, I'm going to bend my knees slightly. My toes are turned out quite far. Some people will go even wider than this, but I can feel in my psoas and my hip flexors that I just don't have the room for it. I'm still about an inch away, and I'm going to get into a tight position and push my hips back, almost before the squat, and then I'll roll in the same way, push my knees out. I'll take a deep breath, come up, come through, and then drift down, and right back down, facilitating a straight walk as I go through. You can make these movements accessible to you either by any weight that you have available. I love the modification of strapping backpacks onto a broom if you're really looking to get creative. But I wanted to give you this foundational guideline for when you're reintroducing yourself back into the gym as well, to show that the deadlift is a very easy to apply workout that seems so complicated because there's so many steps, but it's still worth doing. In deadlifting, when I pop my chest up, I'm using my pecs. My arms are huge, my shoulders are flexed back, my lats, my long legs, my hamstrings are flared. My glutes are taking some heavy work, so are my hamstrings. Sumo deadlifting emphasizes a little bit more quad than conventional deadlifting does, but either way, you have a whole body workout that is so beneficial in teaching you how to breathe, just burning an incredible amount of energy, really feeling athletic and utilizing your strength and capability, and learning yourself from where you need room for improvement. So, wow, I would just highly advise that you deadlift and video yourself and send me the video or compare notes to other such lifters as maybe someone on the starting to bring Mark Robito variation, or there are some advocates such as Steffi Cohen, who is the current world champion in female category 4 deadlifting. Incredible girl. You can look at her cues and try to build an artillery of references that you can make in order to really feel powerful and feel functional and feel capable. So really excited to see these videos from you. Have so much fun in discovering this form, and as you can tell, even just the lightest weight, this is just 65 pounds, it makes a difference when you go slow and when you take one. All right, I'll talk to you guys soon. Have fun.